Now, let's discuss some of the details of viruses. First, let's take a look at the structure of virus. A virus infects a program by modifying the program code. That is, the virus code has to be physically inserted into the program file. Logically, when the infected program runs, the virus codes run first, then the original program will run so that user would not suspect that the program has been infected. And then at the end, there could be some virus code that does cleanup to avoid detection. If you look at the infected program, the first line controls that the virus program will always run first. It is critically important to put this control in the first line of the infected program because this is the only way to guarantee that the virus code will always be run whenever the program executes. It is also important to put a marker in the infected program, such as putting a special flag in the second line of the infected program to indicate whether the program has been infected by the virus or not. Otherwise, a program can be repeatedly infected. When the virus code is run, it typically first finds other programs to infect. Of course, it will check whether a program has been infected already by looking at this special flag. In addition to infecting other programs, the virus code can also perform other malicious activities on the system, such as stealing valuable documents. After performing the malicious actions, the virus will then transfer the control to the original program so that the normal work can be performed. In such a way, the user would not notice. The virus code can also perform other actions in order to avoid detection. For example, because the virus code is physically inserted into the original program file, the file size of the original program obviously increases, and this can be a telltale sign that a program has been infected. Therefore, in order to avoid detection, the virus code can compress the infected program so that the file size is the same as the size of the program before it is infected.